Tonight, a teacher fired for using a controversial book to teach about gender identity to her fifth grade class. So the Cobb County School Board voted to fire the teacher, Katie Rinderle, even though a hearing by the tribunal had recommended that she keep her job. 11 Alive John Sherrick is live for us tonight at the Cobb County School Board. John.
The teacher, Katie Rinderle, was here when the school board voted to fire her. Also here, parents who support Rinderle and parents who wanted her gone.
Teacher Katie Rinderle, embracing supporters after the Cobb County School Board voted to fire her. Rinderle declined to comment on camera. Her attorney, Craig Goodmark.
So she's disappointed that it went this way.
Katie Rinderle, a teacher for 10 years, had fought for her job before the tribunal that last week heard the charges against her. The tribunal concluded that Rinderle showed lack of judgment when she read My Shadow is Purple to her fifth grade math class this past March, and then taught her students about themes in the book, about gender identity and gender fluidity. The tribunal called that controversial and said that Rinderle should have known and should have received approval first from the principal and from parents. But the tribunal recommended that Rinderle not be fired, as Superintendent Chris Ragsdale wanted.
That motion carries.
The school board fired her anyway by a vote of 4-3. The three who voted to keep Rinderle: Becky Saylor, Leroy Trey Hutchins, and Nichelle Davis. Rinderle's attorney says teachers statewide are receiving little guidance about what is legal under the state's new law against teaching divisive concepts unless parents consent.
It's impossible for a teacher to know what's in the minds of parents when she starts her lesson, and for parents to be able, with a political agenda from outside the classroom, to come in and have a teacher fired is simply unfair. It's not right. It's terrible for Georgia's education system.
Pamela Reardon is a new grandmother.
I will protect that baby girl till the ends of the earth, and I don't want the teachers indoctrinating them. I want the parents to be parents and the teachers to teach. That's it.
The legislature has teachers in fear for their jobs. They don't know what they can say and what they can't say. I expect that we'll see more of this, unfortunately.
Rinderle's attorney will look into filing a possible appeal, and he says her dismissal does not affect her state teaching certificate, so she could go to work for another school district.